Let's consider this word nationalist, which is a very hot word, and it's in the news today, and it is now raising international concern. President Trump, speaking last month, so in October, speaking at a rally in Houston, brought up this word nationalist, contrasting it with the word globalist. This is what President Trump had to say.
Globalists. You know what a globalist is, right? You know what a globalist is. A globalist is a person that wants the globe to do well, frankly, not caring about our country so much. And you know what? We can't have that. You know, they have a word. It sort of became old-fashioned. It's called a nationalist. And I say, really, we're not supposed to use that word. You know what I am? I'm a nationalist, okay? I'm a nationalist.
All right. Obviously, the crowd loved the comment, I'm a nationalist, not a globalist. Many others cringe when they hear it. Why? Because the term has widely been associated with negative movements, like white supremacist movements, or you're anti-immigrant, anti-people who are not white skin, anti-people of different race, different ethnicity. You say I'm a nationalist, it means I'm xenophobic. It means I'm not just America first, I'm America first in an unhealthy way, and I'm a particular type of America first, namely a white America is a blessed America. That is the way many people hear the word nationalist today. President Trump is using it. Is that wise or unwise? What's his intent in using it? These are fair questions to ask. Let's remember that if you're in Europe and you hear nationalist, you may immediately think of Nazis because they were the nationalist socialist German Workers' Party, Nazi being short for that, for the national party there. And there was a hyper-nationalism in Germany that led to World War I and that led to World War II. So President Trump has been in Europe. He was in France. And on the anniversary of the 100th year of the end of World War I, Prime Minister Macron of France said this, and he was specifically reacting to, he didn't mention Trump by name, but the rise of Russian nationalism, of American nationalism. What does that mean? When in Europe, you want to have a healthy and strong Europe. That's what you want to emphasize more than an individual country's nationalism. So he said this, old demons are reawakening, ready to sow chaos and death. He said, history sometimes threatens to repeat its tragic patterns and undermine the legacy of peace we thought we had sealed with the blood of our ancestors. And then he said this, patriotism is the exact opposite of nationalism. Nationalism, he said, is a betrayal of patriotism. By pursuing our own interests first, with no regard to others, we erase the very thing that a nation holds most precious, that which gives it life and makes it great, its moral values. All right, now, the contrast between patriotism and nationalism may have some of you scratching your heads because you might say, when I talk about patriotism, I mean nationalism. When I talk about nationalism, I mean patriotism. And that's what I'm thinking about. And that's my mindset and that's my mentality. If you say it in Europe or if certain ethnic groups here in America, they are going to hear it differently. So is the solution to pull out a dictionary? Well, no, the word means this. No, the dictionary is not going to define how people think and what they perceive. And again, different groups are going to hear this differently based on their own background. But even in Europe, there is a push against globalism and even just an all-European type of mentality. For example, Prime Minister Viktor Orban of Hungary, some would call him far right, but certainly a to-the-right politician with strong Christian foundations, he's pushed back in his own country against the rise of Islam and the rise of Islam in Europe. And he said, look, it's our Christian history that gives us the foundation for Europe. And if we surrender that, we surrender who we are. And didn't Angela Merkel in Germany, didn't she make it a law? It was passed a few years back that if you're an immigrant and you want the full benefits of living in Germany, you have to learn German. Isn't that kind of a nationalism? And what about countries like France that have a burqa ban? Yeah, a burqa ban so that Muslim women cannot wear the full Islamic garb. And what about a country like Switzerland, known for its openness and tolerance, which, 9 years ago, passed a ban on building minarets. So mosques with their distinctive look, and those couldn't be built in that way in Switzerland. Aren't all these countries saying, hey, look, we have a certain national heritage that's important to us. And although we ally together as European nations, our heritage is important to us. And therefore, we find we need to take some steps to preserve it. You say, well, what does that look like in America if we try to preserve our heritage? Does that mean suppressing and oppressing Native Americans and suppressing and oppressing Black Americans and other minorities and Hispanic Americans and Asian Americans? Or does it mean that we're a nation of immigrants, but we are a nation of laws and we have certain background that makes us special? So here's where I see coming. President Trump will be continually attacked for his use of the word nationalism, because of which he will double down and use it more. Then his most ardent supporters, in solidarity with President Trump and pushing back against what they feel is a dangerous globalism, which puts the interest of other nations first to the hindrance of America. In other words, the globalist mentality that Trump supporters would reject is the mentality that says, well, even though this costs our country a lot, it helps other countries. Well, those other countries are prosperous enough. They don't need our sacrifice there. Or, look, we don't want to be too dominant, so we have to give these other organizations and countries more power and more sway. Yeah, but if it hurts our people, then how is that right? And isn't every leader elected? I don't care if you've got the tiniest republic in the world. Isn't every leader elected to take care of the interest of their countries? And that's what you have to deal with first. I mean, obviously. So this is not going away. The word nationalist is going to be used more and more. Some Trump supporters who are to the radical right, the alt-right, they will be cheering him on because to them, this means white supremacy. This means a bigoted, xenophobic America. And Trump critics are going to attack him constantly, especially the ones who have the most extreme globalist mentality. So I propose a positive working definition for nationalists. If the term is going to be used, let's use it like this. And everyone should be able to embrace this. And this is in my latest article, which will be live any hour now. This is my proposal. A nationalist is one who wants to see a strong and healthy America to the benefit of every single citizen in our country from every race and ethnicity. This, in turn, will contribute to a more stable, prosperous world. Let me repeat that. A nationalist is one who wants to see a strong and healthy America. Don't we all want to see that? To the benefit of every single citizen in our country. It is not prejudicial. It is not discriminatory. It is not bigoted. From every race and ethnicity, this, in turn, will contribute to a more stable, prosperous world. All right? So a healthy and strong America that pursues justice for all and liberty for all, and whose blessing and prosperity benefits all of its citizens from every race and ethnicity, that will contribute to a more stable and prosperous world where there are things that must be confronted, evil and injustice in other parts of the world that we must confront. A strong America stands for the good of the whole world. And when there are things that require economic aid and help, a strong and prosperous America helps the entire world. So if you're going to use the word nationalist, let's use it in a positive sense. Let's use it in a sense in which it has been redeemed, used in the past. Let's redeem it if it's been used and abused by others. And let's say to the world that America first does not mean America only. Rather, a strong America is good for the strength of the world, and a strong America is good for all of its citizens equally. Does that work?